Dear students, let's continue the chapter ionic equilibria. From this chapter, today we are going to study auto-ionization of water. Always remember students, pure water ionizes to a very small extent. And you can understand the ionization of pure water by this reaction. When you are taking water, it dissociates into H3O plus means hydronium ion and OH minus means hydroxide ion. And when you are taking it in a formula, dissociation formula, so it gives K is equal to concentration of product upon concentration of reactant. As you have seen in the reactant, we are already used double quantity of water, that's why in the formula we are writing here concentration of H2O square, or you can write this dissociation formula in this manner. As you have seen, concentration of H2O liquid square in a denominator, when it moves opposite side of the equal, so it is in multiplication form. This H2O square in excess quantity means majority of H2O molecules are undissociated. So consequently, the concentration of H2O will become constant. Students, maximum molecules of H2O is undissociated. That's why concentration of water we are taking here constant, and which is denoted by K dash. Substitute this value in equation 1, so we can get K into K dash is equal to concentration of H3O plus into concentration of OH minus. This K into K dash, we can call it ionic product of water, and it is denoted by Kw. So Kw is nothing but a ionic product of water. The product of molar concentration of hydronium or hydrogen ion and hydroxyl ion at equilibrium in pure water at a given temperature. It is nothing but a Kw or ionic product of water. I'm explain again. Kw is the product of molar concentration of hydronium or hydrogen ion and hydroxyl ion at equilibrium in pure water at a given temperature is called ionic product of water. Now students, always remember, in pure water hydronium ion concentration is always equal to hydroxyl ion concentration. For pure water, hydronium ion means H3O plus concentration is always equal to OH minus ion concentration. Thus at 298 Kelvin, this concentration value will be 1.0 into 10 raised to minus 7 mole per liter. Now put this value in the equation or in the formula, in this formula, so we will get Kw is equal to 1.0 into 10 raised to minus 7 into 1.0 into 10 raised to minus 7. So the value will be 1.0 into 10 raised to minus 40. It is for pure water. For pure water, हाइड्रोनियम आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इज इक्वल टू हाइड्रोक्सिल आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन एन एच 298 केल्विन. द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस कॉन्सेंट्रेशन आर 1.0 × 10⁻⁷ मोल पर लीटर. वी कैन पुट दिस वैल्यू इन दिस फॉर्मूला सो वी विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ के डब्ल्यू. के डब्ल्यू इज नथिंग बट द आयनिक प्रोडक्ट ऑफ वाटर एंड द वैल्यू इज 1.0 × 10⁻¹⁴. So this is nothing but a auto ionization of water. The next topic in this chapter is pH scale. You all are aware about the pH. Actually, what is pH scale? Instead of writing concentration of hydronium ion in mole per decimeter cube, it is easy or convenient to express it on the logarithm scale. This is known as pH scale or potency of hydrogen. So we can define the pH of the solution as the negative logarithm to the base 10 of the concentration of H plus ion in solution in mole per decimeter cube. pH of a solution as the negative logarithm to the base 10 of the concentration of H plus ion in solution in mole per decimeter cube, and mathematically we can write it as pH is equal to minus log to the base 10 concentration of H plus ion. Same here we can write the formula of pOH. Negative logarithm means minus log to the base 10 concentration of OH minus ion. Means pOH of a solution can be defined as the negative logarithm to the base 10 of molar concentration of OH minus ion in solution. I am repeating here. pOH of a solution can be defined as the negative logarithm to the base 10 of the molar concentration of OH minus ion in solution. So these are the definitions of pH and pOH. Now the next topic is relationship between pH and pOH. Student, we have already studied the ionic product of water and the formula of ionic product of water and the value of ionic product of water at 298 Kelvin. So the ionic product of water formula is KW. KW is nothing but ionic product of water, and the formula is concentration of H3O plus concentration of OH minus, and at 298 Kelvin the value of KW is 1 × 10⁻⁴. Now put this value in the formula, so we will get concentration of H3O plus concentration of OH minus is equal to 1.0 × 10⁻⁴. Now taking logarithm of both the side of this equation, so we will get log to the base 10 concentration of H3O plus plus log to the base 10 concentration of OH minus is equal to log to the base 10⁻⁴. As we have already known, powers and no log, so the formula will become log to the base 10 concentration of H3O plus plus log to the base 10 concentration of OH minus is equal to minus 14 log to the base 10 10. Log to the base 10 10 means log 10, and we know that log 10 is equal to 1. So what is remaining here? Actually only minus 14. Now student, multiply this whole the equation by minus 1. Whenever you multiply this equation by minus 1, so you will get minus log to the base 10 concentration of H3O plus plus minus log to the base 10. Concentration of OH minus is equal to minus 1 into minus minus plus. So we will get plus 40. Now minus log to the base 10 concentration of H3O plus, we know that it is pH. Then plus minus log to the base 10 concentration of OH minus is nothing but a POH, and it is equal to 14. So what is the relationship between pH and POH? pH plus POH is equal to 14. So how we will get, or how we will derive the relation between pH and POH? First, we are using the formula of ionic product of water. Put the value of ionic product of water, taking logarithm of the equation, then multiply the equation by minus 1, and then put the values. So it is the relationship between pH and POH, means pH plus POH is equal to 40. Now the next topic is hydrolysis of salt. Student, as you have already known what is hydrolysis. For studying this topic, we have to first study the types of salt. Actually, what is types of salt? And acidity, basicity, and neutrality of aqueous solution. So before we are going to study the hydrolysis of salt, first we are going to study the neutral solution. So student, always remember, for pure water or any aqueous neutral solution at 298 Kelvin, concentration of hydronium ion is equal to concentration of hydroxyl ion, means is equal to 1.0 into 10^2 minus 7 molar. It means that pH is equal to 7 for neutral solution. For acidic solution, in acidic solution there is excess of H3O plus ion, means excess of hydronium ion, or you can say concentration of hydronium ion is greater than concentration of hydroxyl ion. For acidic solution, concentration of hydronium ion is greater than concentration of hydroxyl ion, that's why pH of the solution is lower than 7. For basic solution, concentration of hydronium ion is lower than concentration of hydroxyl ion, that's why pH of the solution is greater than 7. So for neutral solution, concentration of hydronium ion is equal to concentration of hydroxyl ion, that's why pH is equal to 7. For acidic solution, concentration of hydronium ion is greater than concentration of hydroxyl ion, that's why pH is lower than 7. For basic solution, concentration of hydronium ion is lower than concentration of hydroxyl ion, that's why pH is greater than 7. Now the types of salt. There are 4 types of salt. The first type is the salt which is derived from strong acid and strong base. Means the salt which is derived from strong acid and strong base. And the example is NaCl, sodium chloride, potassium nitrate, sodium nitrate, etc. It is the first type. The second type is the salt which is derived from strong acid and weak base. and the example is ammonium chloride, copper sulfate, ammonium nitrate, etc. The third type of salt is the salt which is derived from weak acid and strong base. And the example is sodium acetate, sodium carbonate, etc. The fourth type of salt is the salt which is derived from weak acid and weak base. And the example is ammonium acetate, ammonium cyanide, etc. So there are four types of salt. One is salt derived from strong acid and strong base. Second one, from strong acid and weak base. Third one, weak acid and strong base. And the fourth one, weak acid and weak base. Now we are going to study what is hydrolysis, concept of hydrolysis. So student, the definition of hydrolysis is, hydrolysis of salt is defined as the reaction in which cation or anion or both the ion of the salt react with the ion of water, both the ion of the salt, either cation, either anion, react with the ion of water to produce acidity or alkalinity or sometimes neutrality. See, when a salt is dissociated in water, it dissociates completely into its constituent ion. The solvent water dissociates slightly. Always remember, student, salt is dissociated in water, means water acts as a solvent. And the solvent water dissociate slightly, as we have already seen this equation. So for pure water is neutral, and in this concentration of hydronium ion is equal to concentration of hydroxyl ion. I am repeating, student, salt dissociated in water completely means water act as a solvent, but solvent water dissociated slightly, and pure water is always neutral, in which concentration of hydronium ion is equal to concentration of hydroxyl ion. If the ion of the salt do not interact with water, the hydronium and hydroxyl ion concentration remain equal and the solution is neutral. When one or more salt ion react with water, the equality of concentration of hydronium ion and hydroxyl ion is disturbed. So the solution is does not remain neutral. Always remember, student, if ion of any salt does not react with water, it means the solution is neutral. But when one or more of the salt ion react with the water, so there is no equality of concentration of hydronium ion and hydroxyl ion, and the solution is does not remain neutral, and it may be become acidic or basic. It is depending upon the type of salt. And such reaction between the ion of the salt and ion of the water is called hydrolysis of salt. Ion of the salt when react with ion of the water, it is called hydrolysis of salt. And always remember, when ion of the salt and ion of the water does not react, so the solution will be neutral, means pure water is neutral. We are going to study different types of salt. First type is salt of strong acid and strong base, and we are taking the example NaCl. NaCl is the salt which will derive from HCl means strong acid and NaOH means strong base. So NaCl is a salt which is nothing but a derived from strong acid and strong base. The strong acid which is used is HCl and strong base which is used is NaOH. And NaCl is completely dissociated in water and produce Na plus and Cl minus ion. Here we are adding here aqueous means salt is dissolved in water and dissociated completely and produce Na plus and Cl minus ion. So the ion Na plus and Cl minus have no tendency to react with water. This is because the possible product NaOH and HCl of such reaction are a strong electrolyte and dissociate completely in aqueous solution. We can understand by this reaction Na plus plus Cl minus plus H2. It will give HCl plus NaOH. HCl plus NaOH. When we reverse this equation, means HCl plus NaOH plus H2O, so it will give H3O plus plus Cl minus plus Na plus plus OH minus. So student, when salt of strong acid and strong base, for example NaCl, it produces Na plus and Cl minus ion and it have no tendency, means the ion Na plus and Cl minus have no tendency to react with water. This is because the possible product, as we have already seen, the possible product when Na plus and Cl minus dissociated in water, so the possible product is HCl and NaOH. And which are the strong electrolyte and dissociate completely in aqueous solution. As we have already seen these two reactions, how it is dissociated. Thus, the reactant and product are the same. This implies that neither the cation nor anion of the salt react with water. Means there is no hydrolysis. Student, there is no hydrolysis. Hydrolysis means ion of salt react with water, ion of water. But there is no reaction between ion of salt and ion of water. Means neither cation nor anion of the salt react with water. So there is no hydrolysis. And equality H3O plus means hydronium ion and OH minus ion. Means H3O plus ion is equal to OH minus ion. And it is produced by ionization of water. And it is not disturbed and the solution is neutral. So always remember, salt of strong acid and strong base does not undergo hydrolysis because the reactant and products are the same. And Na plus and Cl minus ion does not react with water. So no hydrolysis is carried out for these types of salt. The next is the salt of strong acid and weak base. And we are taking here the example of such type of salt is copper sulfate, which is derived from strong acid H2SO4, means sulfuric acid, and weak base means copper hydroxide. So copper sulfate dissociated as Cu2 plus plus SO4 2 minus. And student, remember SO4 2 minus ion of the salt have no tendency to react with water. because the possible product is H2SO4 and it is a strong electrolyte. Possible product is H2SO4 and it is a strong electrolyte. So the reaction of Cu2+ and OH, Cu2+ ion with OH- ion form unionized CuOH2, which we can understand by this reaction. Cu2+ when react with water, it gives CuOH2+2H3O+ ion. Due to presence of excess of H3O+ ion, the resulting solution of copper sulfate become acidic and turn blue litmus red. Student, I am repeating here. When copper sulfate dissociated, it produced Cu2+ + SO4 2-. And copper sulfate is nothing but a salt which is derived from strong acid and weak base. And SO4 2- ion of the salt have no tendency to react with water because the possible product of H2SO4 is strong electrolyte. And the reaction of Cu2+ and water produce unionized CuOH2, means copper hydroxide plus hydronium ion. Hydronium ion produced in an excess quantity, which resulting the solution of copper sulfate become acidic and turn blue litmus red. Now, the next type is salt of weak acid and strong base. We are taking an example, sodium acetate is a salt which is derived from weak acid means acetic acid and strong base means NaOH. When it is dissolved, it dissociates completely and form acetate ion and sodium ion. And as we have already known, water dissociated slightly as hydronium ion and hydroxyl ion. So the solution of sodium acetate contain Na+ ion, H3O+ ion, CH3CO- ion and OH- ion. The solution of, as we have seen already these two equations, so we can understand when sodium acetate dissolve in water, it produce Na+ ion, H3O+ ion, acetate ion and OH- ion. Sodium ion of the salt have no tendency to react with OH- ion of water, since the possible product of the reaction is NaOH. Means when sodium react with OH- ion, it produces NaOH. So Na+ ion does not react with OH- ion because it produces NaOH and it is nothing but a strong electrolyte. On the other hand of the reaction, acetate ion, acetate means CH3COO- ion of the salt with the hydronium ion form from water produce unionized acetic acid. Means sodium ion react with OH- ion and produce NaOH and it is a strong electrolyte, and acetate ion with water react to form unionized acetic acid molecule. Thus when we are taking the reaction, so it is clearly seen sodium acetate react with water produce acetic acid plus Na+ plus OH-. As a result of excess of OH- ion, the solution become basic. Therefore sodium acetate solution is basic. Because the excess of OH- ion produced in the solution. That's why the solution of sodium acetate is basic. Now the next type is salt of weak acid and weak base. Here we are using the general salt Ba, which is derived from Ha is nothing but a weak acid, and BOH, which is nothing but a weak base. The hydrolysis of the reaction involves the interaction of both the ion of the salt with the water. So when both the ion means Ba dissociated as B plus and A minus, and it is react with water, produce BOH and Ha. The solution may turn out acidic, basic or neutral, which is depending upon the relative strength of weak base and weak acid formed in the hydrolysis. The solution may be acidic, solution may be basic, solution may be neutral. It is depend on the strength of weak acid and weak base. There are some conditions when the solution become acidic, basic and neutral. As we have already known, the constant, or we have already studied in the previous lecture, dissociation constant of weak acid or weak base. Dissociation constant of weak acid is nothing but a Ka, and weak base is nothing but a Kb. So when Ka is greater than Kb, the solution is acidic. Reverse here, when Ka is lower than Kb, the solution is basic, and when Ka is equal to Kb, the solution will be neutral. So there are three conditions by which we can understand the solution is acidic, basic or neutral. In the next lecture, student, we are going to study salt of acid and bases, for weak acid and weak bases, with the Ka and Kb values. For today's lecture, I am going to conclude my lecture. I hope you will understand. Thank you so much.